My name is Dr. P.C. Patel, Chief Soil Health Specialist and Professor, Mati Mati Agromart Private Limited, Anand, Gujarat. Today, the topic is methods of fertilizer recommendation to crops. So there are two approaches for the fertilizer recommendation. So an approach for giving fertilizer recommendation refers to the way conclusion are drawn based on soil test. The best approach for making fertilizer recommendation depend on several factors such as type of soil, economics, and cropping system. The combination between the buildup and maintenance concept is widely used. There are four basic fertilizer recommendation, but we have seen here two: buildup and maintenance, and second one is sufficiency. So first, the built-up and maintenance approach has been widely used. So the built-up and maintenance philosophy take the approach of first building up the soil fertility level to the high category with addition of specific nutrient whose indexes were interpreted as medium or lower as per the soil test. The strategy here is to maintain soil fertility for future years, means for longer time. The goal is to apply more nutrient than the crop removes so that the nutrient level in the soil is not limiting the yield. So suppose you grow the maize crop, then the requirement of the nitrogen is 100 kg, then we have to apply 150, 200 kg nitrogen. So here we can add more nutrient, particularly for the future use. And the plant have no limiting of the particular nutrient. The fertilizer recommendation are made to apply enough fertilizer to both meet the nutrient requirement of the crop, means whatever you crop grown, that nutrient required by the crop, and to build up the nutrient level in the soil to a critical soil test level over a plant time frame. So for future use or for future years, soil level test level is maintained at or above the critical level by applying fertilizer rates that replace the nutrient removed by the crops. So you grow the crops, then whatever is nutrient removed by the crops, so we have to add more nutrient. We have to consider the nutrient removed by the crops, plus we have to add extra nutrient so that there will be no possibility of the critical soil test limit. The buildup and maintenance approach, this philosophy uses yield goal provided by the farmer so that crop nutrient removal value can be calculated. The fertilizer recommendations are made from the calculated nutrient removal values. This approach does not consider natural contribution from the soil whatsoever. So we have not considered the nutrient supply by the native soil. For calculating crop removal of nutrient, a soil test is not even required. Yield and tissue concentration of nutrient can be used to calculate the amount removed from any particular field. Suppose you take the maize crop or corn crop, then you have to calculate, suppose 4,000 kg grain yield, then suppose 6,000 kg water yield, diameter yield, then you have to consider the concentration of the nutrient, and then you can calculate how much nutrient uptake by the grain yield of the maize or corn and the store yield of the maize or corn. So accordingly, we can calculate the crop removal of the nutrient. So accordingly, we have to add the nutrient in soil. So it is, you can see here, suppose here we have carried out the soil test level low, then we have to apply more particular nutrient for the crop to be grown and for the built up the soil nutrient. So here we have to maintain the soil test level. Then when there is a high, so draw down soil test. So fertilizer rate, you can see here, as the level is low, then the fertilizer rate is high. But when the soil test level is high, then the fertilizer level will require lesser. But we have to maintain the, we have to apply the nutrient in between the maintenance range, means critical level and maintenance limit. So we have to apply the nutrient for the removal of the particular crop to be grown and for the build up the soil for the future years. Then second approach is sufficiency approach. In the sufficiency approach, fertilizer applied only to meet the nutrient requirement of the crop. Suppose you grow only the corn or maize crop, then we have to apply that much fertilizer in the soil. We are not worried for the future or next year. The goal of this approach is to maximize profitability in a given year while minimizing fertilizer application and cost. You know that the fertilizer cost is increasing. So we have to apply the not too much fertilizer, but the required fertilizer required for the crops. That much fertilizer we have to add in soil. So we are getting the maximum profitability in a particular year. When soil test level are low, fertilizer rate that are higher, then the nutritional removal of the crops are recommended. So here you can do that when we are carried out the soil analysis, then there is a low, medium, and high. So when the soil test value is low, then fertilizer rate that are higher than the nutrient removal of the crop are recommended. When soil test level are high, reaching the critical soil test level, the recommendation decreased to almost zero. So suppose your soil have a high nitrogen, phosphorus, or potassium, then you reduce the particular amount of the nutrient less than 50% of the recommended dose, or you can omit. There is no need to apply the particular nutrient when there is a high level of the nutrient. So here we can increase the profitability for a particular year, for 1 year, or one season. But next year, season or next year, we have to add the nutrient. A positive aspect of the sufficient concept is that yield are maximized while annual input are minimized. So we require minimize the annual input. So we are getting the more profit. However, application will need to be every year to maintain those yield levels. So every year we have to carry out the soil analysis, or we have to calculate the crop removal by the yield or the tissue testing. So we have to add the nutrient every year. Fertilizer based on sufficient level is well suited for short-term leases. Percent sufficiency for in mobile nutrient like phosphorus and potassium can be expressed as a percentage of the potential yield when the nutrient is limited and independent of the environment. For example, the regional yield potential for winter wheat is suppose 5 tons per hectare, but the soil test indicate the P level is 80% sufficient, then the maximum yield you should expect is 4 tons per hectare. That is the 5 ton plus here 80%. So you get the 4 ton yield per hectare. Each crop has a specific sufficiency index and recommended application rate for each nutrient. So accordingly, each crop has a specific sufficiency, and accordingly we can add the nutrient in a soil. So the sufficiency approach, suppose here there is a potassium and phosphorus. So you can see that the crop is soybean. So soybean respond better to potassium than phosphorus. So here you can see that here we can get 70, suppose kg yield, then here we are getting only 66. So potassium response is less as compared to the phosphorus. So it depends upon the crop to be grown. Then fertilizer recommendation to weight. So when we recommended to the fertilizer to the wheat crop in Punjab, suppose nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium, then we should have to look the rainfall pattern and fertility level also. So suppose low rainfall area, then we have to recommend it 55-55-60 kg NPK per hectare. When there is a medium rainfall area, then we can recommend it to the farmer 85-55-60 kg NPK per hectare. In high rainfall area, we have recommended to the farmer 110, 85, and 60 kg NPK per hectare. Here you can see why we are applying more NPK fertilizer, because due to heavy rainfall, the nutrient has been lost, leached down. Whereas in low rainfall, there will be less chances of the leaching loss. So here we are getting the lesser recommendation dose of the NPK. Average irrigated area, then it is 110, 55, and 60 kg NPK per hectare. Reach irrigated area, then we have to apply 85, 55, 0 kg NPK per hectare. Then low fertility irrigated area. Suppose your soil have a irrigated area is there where there is sufficient rainfall, but the fertility is low, then we should have to apply high rate of nitrogen and phosphorus. So 135 kg nitrogen, 110 kg P2O5 and 0 kg K2O per hectare. Key to get maximum benefit from fertilizers. So to get maximum benefit from fertilizer, we should follow the following practical point, 4R concept. 4R concept means right type of fertilizer with favorable chemical and physical properties, right time application. So right time of fertilizer application, time of application should synchronize with the rapid crop uptake period, and there should be only a minimum time for soil fertilizer interaction. Then right dose of fertilizer based on the nutrient supplying power of soil and crop need. So for right dose, we have to carry out the soil analysis before sowing of the crops. Then we can choose or we can know the right dose of fertilizer, and we can apply the right dose of the fertilizer NPK or micronutrient deficient. Then we apply that nutrient in the soil, we can get the higher crop production and higher profit. Then right method. So we have used the right method, band method, foliar application, sprinkler, and so on. So here, you know that best place for soil analysis. So Sivama Agri Clinic and Agri Laboratory, Bhavnagar, Gujarat, India is the best place for soil analysis. I am working at Sivama Agri Clinic and Agri Laboratory as a chief soil health specialist. I did PhD in soil science and I have 40 years experience. Then you know that those farmers who want to carry out soil, water and plant analysis, they can put up online order to Amazon, Flipkart to purchase of Sivama soil testing kit, and they can send soil, plant or water sample directly to Sivama Agri Clinic and Agri Laboratory, Bhavnagar, Gujarat. Sivama will immediately start to carry out soil testing or analysis on the latest scientific instrument ICPUS and send soil testing report along with the expert advice of the recommended dose of manure and fertilizer of the concerned crop to the farmer through email or post. So on the basis of the soil testing on ICPOEC, I will mail the advice to the farmers. And you know that Sivama will work throughout the India, and we are getting the soil sample, plant sample, water sample for analysis. Recently, we have started the analysis of the fungi, then bacteria and nematodes from the soil as well as the plant. Our website of Sevam Agri Clinic and Agri Laboratory, Bhavnagar, at https://sevamart.in. Then our second format located at the Bhavnagar also, Mati Mati Agro Mart Private Limited, Bhavnagar, Gujarat website, www.matimatiagromart.com. Please contact our helpline number +91 63 59 59 59 59. Suppose you like my video, then please subscribe. Thank you very much. And if you have any problem, then please ask me. Thank you very much.